Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to cover morning tales for 18th July 2019. So it's 8 a.m. in the morning and I'll be covering morning tales for you today. If you do not know about the uploading of morning tales on the website, here I will be telling you all about it so that you can take these tests online itself whenever you want. You'll have the complete flexibility and they're very engaging as well. So morning tales of previous days have already been uploaded, as you can see here, and today we are going to start with morning tales questions for July 18th, 2019. So without wasting any time, let's start with the session and let's discuss some of these questions which are going to be very important for the RBI and SEBI examinations. These questions that I have been discussing in the past through my team have already been proven to be very effective for these examinations. Okay, the first question is, with which organization has Department of Telecommunications signed an MOU to develop the first of its kind broadband readiness index? So whenever the Department of Telecom, with whatever organization they have signed this, come out with an index, so they've already released the index but they've not come out with the details as of now as to which state tops it, which state is doing bad about it, all those things. When they come out with the data, that also is going to be holding a lot of importance. The answer to this question is Indian Council for Research on International Economic Relations, that is D. So the answer to this question is D, ICRIAR, that is the short form of Indian Council for Research, plus Department of Telecommunication. These two organizations have come together in order to create a broadband readiness index. The purpose of this index is to identify which state is doing badly in availability of broadband services, which state is doing well in the availability of internet services, and how to improve these services in the states which are doing badly in them. So it'll be like a reality check and will allow all these states to check whether they are doing good enough in broadband availability or not. Okay. The second question, very important, NASA is observing 50th anniversary of its DASH mission. So in on 21st July 1969, NASA, which is an organization of United States of America, was the first one to send a manned mission to moon. And there were two people who actually landed on moon and came out and walked on moon. And the first one, you must be aware about him, very popular, Neil Armstrong was the first one. And the second one, well, the second one, nobody knows about him. So I would ask you to provide me the name of the second person in the comment section below, just for knowledge purposes, not important for the examination, but provide me the name in the comment section below. And the name is Buzz Aldrin. Buzz Aldrin was the second person to land on moon, who landed, I think, about 20 minutes after Neil Armstrong landed on moon. So this mission was successfully conducted on 21st July 1969 upon an aircraft which was called as Apollo 11. So the answer to this question is C, Apollo 11. We are celebrating 50th anniversary of this feat of first manned mission to the our moon that we have. Okay. The third question is, which country will be hosting ISSF World Cup in the year 2020? Number one question for you guys is, which I will not be answering, but I want you to answer it. I've already discussed it in the past videos. The question is, where was ISSF World Cup 2019 held? So the first question is, where was it held? And the second question is, which country topped or became first in ISSF World Cup 2019? The third question, in fact, let me ask you that also, what is the full form of ISSF? What is the full form of ISSF? The answer to this question is, which country will be hosting ISSF World Cup 2020? The answer to this question is B, India. So India is expected to hold, or given the responsibility to hold, ISSF World Cup in the year 2020. Let's come to the fourth question. I want you guys to answer all these three questions to me for me in the comment section below. It's going to be very interesting. The fourth question is, who has been appointed as the international judge at the Singapore International Commercial Court? With the picture itself, I believe it's going to be very easy for you to answer. He looks like an Indian, so the answer has to be something Indian. The answer is A.K. Sikri. A.K. Sikri has been appointed as international judge at the Singapore International Commercial Court, which deals with commercial issues or commercial litigations. And this court works along with the High Court of Singapore and also the Supreme Court of Singapore. And A.K. Sikri has been a judge of Supreme Court of India. He retired on March 6 this year itself, and he has been a judge of the Supreme Court for a very long time. Okay, let's come to the fifth question for today. How many people have enrolled in PM Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana? So first important news item here is, or first important thing that we need to discuss is, what exactly is PM Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana? In case you remember, pause the video, write everything that you can remember in the comment section below, and that is going to help you recall and have a reality check as to how much do you remember about Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana. What is the primary purpose of Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana? Primary purpose is old age protection. Old age protection and social security. Social security of unorganized workers. Okay. So that is the primary responsibility of PM Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana. And it says that all the people in the unorganized sector who are between the age group or in the age group of 18 to 40 years of age and have a monthly income of less than 15,000 per month are not an income tax payer, because yes, their income is less than 15,000 per month, are eligible to apply for Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana, wherein they will be getting a minimum pension of rupees 3,000 when they cross the age of 60 years. Okay, so that is Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana. The question is, how many people have enrolled in PM Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana till now according to Ministry of Labour and Employment? The answer is A, over 30 lakhs. So this number holds a lot of importance because it shows, number one, the number of people who have been working in the unorganized sector, and the importance of a social security scheme like this. Okay, the sixth and last question for today is, which scientist will feature on Euro 50 Note of Europe? Euro 50 Note of Europe. So which scientist is going to be featuring on Euro 50 Note of Europe? The answer to this question is C. Alan Turing. C. Alan Turing is the answer to this question. He's a English mathematician. He was a computer scientist, a very highly intellectual person, and in the development of theoretical computer science, he had a big role to play. Okay, so that is the reason that he has been awarded with this and he is going to be featuring on the Euro 50 Note. Now, what was the primary contribution of Alan Turing? That is something that's very interesting. During the Second World War, Alan Turing actually worked with the government of Britain in code breaking. So all the information which used to be passed among the different parties which were a part of the war used to be in codes, and the opposition or the both the parties of the war used to get these codes somehow, but it was a task to break these codes and understand what the opposition, what the other party, what the rival was actually planning on doing. And Alan Turing played a big role in that code breaking activity for the Britain government. So that was the primary contribution of Alan Turing towards Britain's government in the Second World War, and that's why he's been given this great feature to be seen on Euro 15 Note now. Okay, so that's all for today's Current Affairs. I hope you liked it. If you did, do not forget to subscribe to the channel Anuj Jindal on YouTube, and do not forget to press the bell icon. Also, please take these morning tales questions regularly, these quizzes regularly on the website. You can take these quizzes as you scroll down when you enter your details. Let's say I enter my details, my first name is this, my email ID is this, and when I go to show my results, I get to see my results. So this way, every day I can see whatever I'm doing. So I get 6 out of 6, that means all the answers were correct. Whatever answers are wrong, I get to know that as well. Okay, so this way you are testing yourself on a daily basis, and that helps you a lot in understanding where do you stand, how are you performing, so on and so forth. Okay, I hope you like the lesson. All the very best. Take care. Have a nice day.